In these changing times, artists and performers across Central Florida are creating new ways to connect with the world. They're sharing their gifts and inspiring us through social media, right from their living rooms. You're watching a new show on Vision TV called Live From Home, and we're starting in 3, 2, 1. Host Renata Sago. Thank you for the company here in my living room set. Well, many Central Florida businesses are now beginning to reopen after weeks under quarantine. This will eventually include dance studios. That's where our guests for today were bringing the sensual and saucy energy of salsa before COVID hit. The dance studio has been bringing original performances and competitions to this area since 1999. That's Salsa Heat Dance Studio. It was actually one of the first places I heard about when I moved here. It was a spot to learn. That's what everyone told me. Eymar Marcano and his dance partner, Giselle Rivera, over the past few weeks, their team of instructors have been offering online classes. Hola, Eymar and Giselle.
Hi, Renata. How are you?
I'm so great. How are you?
We're doing awesome. Yes. So far, so good.
All right. You look great. Well, salsa is so tied to Central and South Florida's identity. People come here and they want to learn salsa dance. Have you been able to feel that energy through your online classes, even in the midst of the quarantine?
Well, the connection, it's a little bit different, to be honest. Since we can't see them on, person to person, what we're trying to do is at least stay connected, it's great for them because, they can do it at their houses, they don't have to come out to the studio or anything like that. Mainly for the people that have partners, like husband and wife, boyfriend or girlfriends, sisters and brothers, But for the people that are single, for example, that always come to the studio, it's just been a little bit harder because they don't have that partner with them for us to be able to teach partner work and turn patterns and all of that we normally do in our classes. So it's a little bit more challenging for them, if you can say.
Wow. And so you are originally from Venezuela, right? And Giselle, you have some
Correct.
Puerto Rican and some Panamanian descent in you. Can you tell us a bit about what the difference in movements are? Your partners, but you're bringing your own sort of style to the mix.
Well, in Venezuela, when I used to dance, when I was living there, I used to dance what they call street salsa, which is what you learn when you're growing up. You dance it at the house parties, you add your own flavor to it, but there is no structure per se. So you just dance to whatever you hear. Now, I think one of the good things about that is that you develop this style or flavor that you naturally bring to the dance. Once, in my case, once I got here and I found out about the salsa classes, which is when I found Salsa Heat, I started taking beginners classes to be able to learn the way they were doing it here. With all the counts and the structure and the turn patterns. And then as I got used to that, then I started adding my own flair, my own style, and flavor that I had while I was growing up. I don't think there is such thing as somebody that doesn't know how to dance, because if you can hear something, you can hear the music. However you move is however you are interpreting the music, so that's dancing. Now, if you want to learn a different style, then, you know, you got to commit to it and learn the way they do. Mommy?
Well, I started in Salsa Heat when I was 5. So I didn't really start dancing till 5. Like, I did ballet, like all the little other styles that little girls did, and jazz and stuff like that. But I took beginner's class here in Salsa Heat and just grew from there.
Wow, 5 years old.
That's one of the beautiful things about this job.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's okay. No, I was going to say, this is the beautiful thing about this, that you can see people grow. Like, we've known Giselle since she was a little kid, and now she's a grown woman, you know. And she's been dancing with us for so many years.
Yeah, it's beautiful when you could see someone just start at 5 years old. That's such a young age, and really nurture them as a talent. And then years later, you're sitting on a sofa preparing to show us a performance. I mean, it's really exciting. I'm just curious, for people who are really interested in salsa dance and they haven't really started and they're about to see you perform and they really want to get involved, what are some suggestions that you have for people who are sort of new to the dance and wanting to learn at some point?
Well, the first thing is get over the fear. A lot of people don't come or think a lot about coming because they've never done it. You know, thankfully our classes are very friendly, and the whole atmosphere of everybody that comes, you know, the whole class is really fun. Which is the goal, you know. We're teaching and they're learning, but never forgetting that it's about the fun, you know. Making sure that they're having a great time, making sure that as they're having a great time, they're learning what they need to learn to be able to have fun on the dance floor. And it's something that we always tell them as they're learning is make sure that your partner is having a great time. It's never about one person or the other person. The goal is to connect with the music as a couple and be able to enjoy the music. So I'll just suggest to just come out. A lot of people ask what to wear. You know, you can wear anything that you're comfortable in. You don't have to wear heels for the beginner's classes because it's just the basics. So you can bring your sneakers. Not sandals, but like the women's shoes,
like flats
and stuff like that. And just come out, you know, a lot of people just come to meet people, get to know other people. We know of friendships that now have been long time friendships that they all started here, you know, so just come out. And you are promised a good time. You're going to have a great time.
Yeah, I mean, you say come out, but the reality is for now, people are staying in. So people can wear gym shoes, they can wear flats, they could wear heels or nothing at all if they want to participate in your virtual classes, right?
Oh, well, yeah, I'm thinking about the future, right? Yeah, no, but we have our online classes. I suggest them that if they can follow Salsa Heat Dance Studio on Facebook and Instagram, so that way they stay connected and can follow the classes that we've been doing or that we're about to do. That way they can register, you know. So they can also go to our website, which is salsaorlando.com, and then we have all the information up there. We're always updating the info, so everybody's up to date.
Okay, awesome. So we do have a performance coming up from you. Before we get into that, I did want to ask you, you mentioned that you're thinking about the future, and so much of us are, especially if you're a creative in Central Florida. Curious, what do you think about the way in which you will be doing your classes in the future? How people will be dancing salsa in the future? I mean, I've seen some people who are wearing these special masks and you know, they've got embroidery and sort of studs on them, sort of making it fancy and costumey. Is there any direction mm-hmm. that this could go, you think, with that?
Yes. Well, since this started before everything closed down, we were already taking some measures. Like, we had hand sanitizers everywhere. We were telling the students that as soon as they got to the studio to go wash their hands, you know, and be mindful. And even, you know, if they have their partners, so they could stay together and not rotate. Now, for when we open, we have done some polls on Facebook, obviously to kind of see if people will be interested to start or how soon will be to start, you know, to be able to open up the studio whenever the government allowed us. Some people or most people are scared to come back. So I think the online classes are going to be here for a little while. Some people, they're excited and waiting for us to reopen. The goal is, if we reopen, I believe we'll be doing limited spots. So they will have to buy the class online, and then they secure their spots. So we're not going to have everybody just come in. And we'll be requiring also for them to be couples, just for now, and to wear a mask, you know, and all of that stuff that we've been doing. So that's pretty much what's gonna happen. When they allow us to open, I think only two things can happen. The first one is gonna be really slow for us, since everybody's still scared, you know, you gotta get in contact with other people you wanna dance with. Or it's gonna be really busy because everybody misses dancing. Like, we do the classes, we do dance socials, which is a party we do on the weekends, so everybody can come and dance, you know. So a lot of people are missing that. So it's either gonna be really busy, then we're gonna have to control maybe the amount of people that we allowed in, or it's going to be really slow because people are going to want to wait until, you know, everything dies down. So we just got to wait and see, you know?
Yes. Well, I know that we can wait no longer to see the performance that you have in store for us right now on Live From Home. So let's clap it up for Salsa yes. Heat Dance Studio performing a special dance.
Thank you.
gosh, let's clap it up for Salsa Heat Dance Studio. Eymar, Giselle, that was phenomenal. Okay, so the movements that we've seen, we talked a bit about you bringing your own flair into this, but what did you just do? I mean, I saw a spin, I saw some kicking. Where does this come from?
Well, this is a choreography. Normally, we pick a song that we like. We like the pace, we like the musicality, and then we create a choreography for it. We practice during the week. We practice to that song, that specific choreography, and then we get to perform it. We do dance events, salsa congresses, competitions sometimes. We do private events. You know, it's always an on. It's very busy, you know. So, and it keeps us going. You know, it keeps us busy. It keeps us working all the time.
Well, you mentioned a bit about how people can stay in touch. People who know salsa already, people who are looking to learn the dance. Can you repeat just quickly where people can find you on social media?
Awesome. They can go to Facebook and look for Salsa Heat Dance Studio. Also on Instagram, our Salsa Heat Dance Studio, and our website is salsaorlando.com.
Oh my goodness, thank you.
And they can find all the information about the classes and what we're going to be doing.
Oh my, oh my. Thank you so much, Eymar and Giselle of Salsa Heat Dance Studio. And thank you for joining us on Live From Home. I hope you enjoyed today's show. We're looking for more talent. I know it's out there. You got it. All you have to do is submit your video to live@orangetvfl.net along with your contact info. Do it through Dropbox or WeTransfer, and we might use it on a future episode of Live From Home. Until then, stay well.